Defense Minister Rajnath Singh has given a strong statement on China and said that after 2020 standoff, China realized that this India is not weak. It's an important comment that has come. He's saying that after Galwan, China knew that this is a changed India and has said that the views changed for China with regard to the country. This was interesting also after China lauded the rise of India's military power. Rajnath Singh had said that India does not consider China as an opponent. They do. Also remember, there are references, and what has got noticed is a recent piece in the Global Times, which is considered as a mouthpiece of China, to which Defense Minister basically also quoted of how underscored that even Beijing now acknowledges India's emergence as a key global economic player and a strategic power, attributing to nation's robust economic and foreign policies.
भारत का अपोनेंट है, मेजर अपोनेंट उसे मानते हैं, हम नहीं मानते, चाइना मानता हो, लोग मानते हैं, हम लोग तो किसी को अपोनेंट मानते ही नहीं, कि वो मानता है, लेकिन ग्लोबल टाइम्स में मिस्टर चेंग ने जो कुछ भी लिखा है, यदि उसकी धारणा बनी है, तो मैं सोच रहा था क्यों धारणा बनी, मुझे लगा कि शायद 2020 में जो भारत और चीन के बीच फेस ऑफ हुआ था, उसमें हमारे सेना के जवानों ने जो करिश्मा दिखाया है, जो बहादुरी दिखाई है, शायद उसके कारण चाइना की धारणा भारत के बारे में बदल गई है कि भारत अब कमजोर भारत नहीं रहा, भारत अब दुनिया का ताकतवर देश बन गया है। वैसा नहीं है कि भारत को आंख दिखाकर जो चाहे सो निकल, डिफेंस का जहां तक सवाल है, पहले हम लोगों की हालत तो यह थी कि सारा का सारा हर सामान दुनिया के दूसरे देशों से हम लोग खरीदते थे, सबसे बड़े इंपोर्टर डिफेंस इक्विपमेंट्स के, डिफेंस आइटम्स के हम थे। आज हम दुनिया के टॉप 25 कंट्रीज में हम आकर खड़े हो गए डिफेंस आइटम्स एक्सपोर्ट करने के बाद।
Defence Minister Rajnath Singh is presently in the UK on a three-day visit, and that is when in London he made the speech and remarks, which are of course very clearly also quoting the facts that are coming out even from China with regard to India. Let's get a perspective on this and understand the context. Joining me, India Today's Managing Editor Gaurav Sawant, in this live telecast this morning. Gaurav, it is often said, isn't it, that when an arch rival or an enemy, so to say, acknowledges your growth, that can be a bigger validation too, and that's why Rajnath Singh is saying that China also realizing they can continue to provoke us, but it is this country right now which is on its way to growth.
That indeed is the case. Of course, China praising India will always be looked at with tremendous suspicion in India, given that India has realized that you don't go by what China says, but follow what China does on ground. There's a huge difference in what China may say and what China may actually do on ground. But Defense Minister Rajnath Singh in the United Kingdom, in London, has made a very significant statement that China, after Galwan, realized that India is no pushover and China cannot continue with its salami slicing of Indian territory. The fact remains that Galwan was an eye-opener for China. China thought it may intimidate India and continue to take more territory. But the manner in which, when those 20 brave soldiers of the Indian Army made their supreme sacrifice of their lives, killing, according to Russian agency TASS, 44 Chinese soldiers, by some other intelligence accounts, more than 40 Chinese soldiers, China realized that India is not a pushover. The fact that China amassed close to 50,000 troops on the border, India put around 50,000, in some instances more than 50,000 troops on the border. India did a QPQ operation dominating the Moldo garrison, forcing China for the first time to actually pull back from the friction points. And that pullback may be, just a short pullback on either side. But close to 4 years after that standoff, the two armies remain in that territory, is an indicator of India's strong resolve that India will not permit China to carry out more salami slicing of Indian territory. That's the point that Rajnath Singh is making. Point one. Point two, equally significant is the fact that, that Chinese daily that you were referring to, a mouthpiece of the Chinese government, acknowledges the fact that India is emerging as a global economic power. It's emerging as a very major strategic power. And that is something that China realizes. India is neither in the American camp nor in the Russian camp. And both camps look up to India in instances for global stability. That is where India is playing a very critical role in the 21st century. And as Rajnath Singh pointed out, from being the world's largest arms importer, India is now manufacturing warships and fighter jets and looking at exports.
That Atmanirbharta is clearly reflecting now. I request you to stay on with me, Gaurav, because joining me now in this telecast on the phone line is Sushant Sareen. He's a senior analyst and has been understanding with regard to strategy, political affairs from Pakistan and China in how India is literally facing a constant battle. Gaurav, why don't you take the first question to Sushant here?
Sushant Sareen, how do you look at Rajnath Singh's statement and a statement that's being made in a third country in the United Kingdom that China also realizes that India is not a pushover and that it sees India as a super, as an economic superpower in an emerging strategic power?
Gaurav, I think it is one thing to make these kind of statements at home when you are addressing a domestic audience, and it has certain political benefits. But going to a third country and speaking this kind of stuff, I don't think it makes a lot of sense. Number one, quoting Global Times, for God's sake, it's a tabloid, English language tabloid of the Chinese state media. Quoting Global Times to project yourself as some kind of an emerging power, I don't know how much sense it makes, especially when you're in the West. Secondly, I think it betrays a kind of lack of understanding of how strategy works. For the Chinese would like nothing better than for India not to be in the American camp or any other camp, which kind of balances their power out. They would love for it. And so they will beguile you, they will seduce you, they will cajole you to not be part of any larger alliance. Because then that means that they can pick at you individually. If you become part of a larger and a stronger alliance, then the Chinese get a little stuck up on what they can or cannot do with us. Yes, it is a fact, and out here I'll completely agree with the Raksha Mantri, that the robust response of the government of India to the Chinese aggressive moves along the LAC did convey a very, very strong message to the Chinese that we are not going to be a pushover for them. And they have Their whatever advance they were trying to make has been stalled. But that is about it. As of now, China remains an extremely hostile country. They are not ready to accept India as a country which is soon going to be the third largest economy in the world. They're not ready to accept us as a country which is going to be a manufacturing and a services hub in the world. They will do everything to sabotage it. They will do everything to counter us strategically by propping up smaller countries like Maldives, Pakistan, and whatever else they can find and throw at us. So they will continue to do all of that. So they are an inimical and hostile country, and that hasn't changed. So I think...
Is what Defense Minister is talking about. One, India emerging as an arms manufacturer, India holding off China at the LAC, and he's only quoting Global Times the way I understand it, that even the adversary acknowledges that we are not in any camp. We are neither in the American camp nor in the Russian camp. But the bigger point is India standing up to China, no longer permitting salami slicing, and Galwan opened China's eyes to India's emerging power. Is he correct on that?
No, I don't think the Chinese are still ready to accept India as an emerging power. They are not ready to accept India as they would want to stall it. They would want to damage India every which way possible. They will say all the nice stuff that we want the peaceful coexistence and all that typical Chinese lingo which they use. But beyond that, their actions on the ground will remain inimical. Secondly, I think it's a very bad idea to quote Chinese media and find validation of your policies and your accomplishments from Chinese media. I don't think it's a very good policy. We should treat China with a lot of contempt, healthy contempt, because then that puts them in their place, which is exactly how they normally treat us. So I don't see any reason why we should give so much respect to the Chinese or the Pakistanis or anybody else who do not give us reciprocate that respect to us. That's the second point I want to make. Third point I want to make is that, you know, as far as the response is concerned, yes, that response has been there. But look, Gaurav, you know better than me that, you know, we have a very long way to go before we become a major defense platform manufacturer, right? Defense weapons manufacturer. We've embarked on that mission, but we have a long way to go before we can do stuff which we really need to be doing. The good part is that we've started on it. The good part is that we've started involving the private sector in this particular field. So a lot of good initiatives have been taken, but we haven't reached that yet.
True, absolutely, Pooja. That remains a fact. In defense manufacturing, a lot more needs to be done, a lot more involvement of the private sector is required, especially in research and development, for India to be able to take it to the next level. But Rajnath Singh making a point about India's strong response at Galwan is something that the world acknowledges, Pooja.
That has come in from Sushant Sareen and Gaurav Sawant. I appreciate and thank both of you for joining us with your perspective. Remember at this time that mission has started. The mission of ensuring that we also start to manufacture our weapons, arms and ammunition, not just depend as an importer from other countries. It will be a long haul. China has definitely reached that milestone years ago, but that is what the difference is in this new India. But what's interesting is that the Global Times, which is considered as mouthpiece of China, of Chinese government, has constantly been targeting in India. And yet recently, just about 2 to 3 days ago, there was an article that was mentioned in the same Global Times. And what is said has clearly caught the eye. Perhaps is it an acknowledgement of even China realizing India is on the path of growth? Here's what the Global Times said. Let me give you an excerpt of some of the words that have been quoted in that article. India is confident, the Global Times article said, under Prime Minister Modi's leadership. So there is perhaps this wave of confidence that has emerged with the new leadership, and that has been now for the past 10 years in the country. But also the Global Times mentions how Modi is building a strong Bharat narrative. Remember, all of this is coming in from a Chinese newspaper article, a digital platform that has constantly been critical of India and of its leadership. So why this change of stance that has come in now? What it also adds in the Global Times, and let's go across to the third point here, India emerging as a world power under Prime Minister Modi. Of course, all of this will have to be very cautiously looked at by India to not just take it as face value, but the fact is, as an arch rival, acknowledging the growth definitely means something. India's domestic policy is improving, which is looking at their domestic interest. Remember, when there are wars going across from West Asia in parts of other continents as well, including in Europe, where there are issues with regard to law and order, it is India looking primarily at domestic interests and an independent foreign policy stand. India is emerging as the fastest growing economy. And with the promise coming in from Prime Minister Modi that from the fifth largest, it's going to be the third largest soon. And it is witnessing. IMF has acknowledged as the spot, bright spot in a dark horizon. Clearly, it appears that even the Global Times is realizing. But like I said, all of this will have to be taken very lightly for now with a caution, considering it is the mouthpiece of the China government, as it is considered, the Global Times, that's always usually attacked India.